Thank you, everybody, for traveling here today, and thank Shane for that wonderful presentation and wonderful answers. My name is Tom Hanrahan, and I work in Limerick. I work for Enable Ireland. Enable Ireland are contracted to provide services to young people and their families who have who live with disabilities. The disabilities that we would be concerned with mainly are spina bifida and cerebral palsy. The OE practice that I have developed, or I'm trying to develop, runs along three strains. One of them is an earth and us program that we put together, and we take small groups of individuals into nature. And the concept is to give them an understanding, or to facilitate an understanding of how they fit into the planet, where they belong, and their place in society. And the second strand is we have a peak adventure program that we run, where we have adapted surfing, adapted kayaking, adapted indoor climbing, and we've recently started to do a whole program around introducing people using a mobi chair to woodlands, rivers, estuaries, and also to beaches. And then the third element that I use outdoor education for the outdoors is my name. The main part of my job is through life coaching. Through the life coaching, I would use nature, and I would use situations in nature to facilitate the young people that I work with to develop their own goals. How I facilitate that, or how I bring it about, is through a process of fascination. Through my experiences with the life coaching, and through my experiences in life and on the course here, I discovered a very interesting gentleman called Jan Ibis Caminus. And he inspired me to look further into available journals, etc., to try and find a concept for how I could develop my work. Caminus, just to quote him, one of the things that he wrote in the 1600s was, "The most important experiences are created by our own senses. We must educate the mind, the tongue, the heart, and the hands." And for me, it was a pivotal moment on the course, and it sent me off on a journey of trying to develop his ideas. And the research took me to a place. It took me to a concept which is well-being. And well-being is described in research as body, mind, and spirit, and it's a combination of those three areas. And how healthy they are. You meet people, you say, "How are you?" "I'm well." You know? So we have the medical model, where people are treated, their health. Then you have the medical body, their people's, their emotions, psychology, and then spirituality. When I talk about spirituality, I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about a sense of spirituality that our search users can gain from being in nature. The concept of the poster is holistic well-being. So holistic, or holism, it directs us to treat the tree, or to approach the three branches of well-being, body, mind, and spirit, in a holistic way. And I discovered that there's a lot of work being done in Singapore, where people are developing well-being and true experiences in nature. And one of the papers that I discovered this describes holism, or the holistic approach to well-being, is that it will deliver harmony and balance to modernity's approach to well-being. When you're researching and you're looking for ideas and you come up with that sort of information, I'm getting a thing here. you know, I actually can't see 3 minutes. Okay. So I hope I've knit that together. I've gone off my notes a little bit, but to finish off, I just like 3 minutes. I'd like to tell you a couple of stories about some of the people that I work with and how these concepts that come out of holistic well-being, how it has affected their life. And if we take quality of life, there was one gentleman that I worked with. When I started working with him, he hadn't got the confidence or the self-determination to go to the shopping center on his own and buy a lottery ticket. And through using life coaching and nature and experiences in nature, he recently acquired an electric wheelchair. He lives in Limerick. He's originally from South Hill. And he travels from the train station in Limerick on adventures all over the city. And he's starting to develop a name for himself. So this is an example of somebody's quality of life that has been changed through, you know, through the HSC and through experiences that he has gained through the life coaching. The second one is sense of life or sense of life purpose. One of the young girls that started on the Earth and Us adventure program, or Earth and Us program, sorry, she, at the very beginning, we were trying to measure how people have progressed, and they asked them questions: where would you find animals? Where would you find wild animals? And her answer was, in a cage. And after a couple of months on the program, we were coming back from the Black Rock Observatory in Cork, having studied the planets and the universe, and where our Earth sat and all of that. And one of the questions that she came up was, if that's where planet Earth is in the solar system, where is heaven? So all of a sudden, her sense of the life purpose, she was starting to question that, and she was starting to examine that. Now, I have a couple more examples, but I'm actually out of time, so I won't start. But what I will do is open up the floor there to any questions. I take off my glasses and I can actually see. So thank you very much for listening.
Hi folks, question time again. Anybody questions for Tom?
Thanks, Tom. It was very interesting. I was interested in the example where you introduced the student to life of gambling. And you mentioned that it was true in the experiences in the outdoors, you know, that he changed his life. Like, what exactly were you introducing him to?
I presume you're referring to the first gentleman that I talked about. But I think as a life coach, you're trying to get people to find goals for themselves, and they need to be intrinsic goals. They're not what I feel a person needs to do, or what an institution, or what the HSE feels that person needs to do. And through fascination, as I mentioned, it's a process where if you take people into an area where they're, it would be, it's a new area, a new concept, a new environment, and if you engage them, the brain will contemplate other issues that may be going on in their life. So by using nature to instigate or to roll out the process of fascination. I think.
Anybody else like to ask Tom a question? Great, so, okay.
Yes.
Thanks, Tom. I'd just like to ask you, what do you see as the barriers to maybe rolling this out on a wider scale in your organisation around Ireland?
Thanks, John. At the moment, I think the biggest problem, and it's across the country, probably across Europe as well, is austerity. And then secondly would be training, staff training. And after that, I think maybe a shift in attitudes again, that would be training probably. Already we see the HSE have delivered their 12 new directions, which there's inclusion, independence, personal, social development. But I think sometimes you can get stuff delivered between the HSE and and maybe some more education. That they would be the three barriers that I would see. Thanks, John.
Okay, great stuff.